And welcome back. Today, I'm going to stop progress. I'm just going to halt everything. Side missions, main missions. This is just going to be like a side video. Ignore it if you want. I'm just going to talk to the crew, because we completely walked past everybody I'll be hanging out with for the rest of this game. Just kind of, I got a ship and just like, woohoo, taking off on a grand adventure. Talk to you losers later. But we're going to talk to some people, whether they want to or not.
You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector.
You're like a giant sentient Cheeto.
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
He designed it. Let's find out about that.
Something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole
guess. I have no idea what that is.
I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
Ugh, it's like I'm getting a spray tan.
We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
Yeah, I've done the same.
I get it. Like leaving a good story half finished.
The team liked that one of us was going.
So we're flying the book.
It felt right.
Neat.
After all we went through. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, three drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing.
Yeah, you know what? There are some events I would not like to relive over and over again in my head. Oh, what the hell's going on with the lighting? Alright, who turned out the sun? Solarian arc. Oh yeah, let's find out about those guys. I completely forgot there's
not a peep.
Other species just floating around lost.
You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company. But it's lonely without other Solarians.
Don't worry. Somewhere out there, there's a giant metal ship floating around full of sentient Cheetos, just like you.
Of course we will. I just have to be patient, that's all. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father.
Why would they mothball a perfectly good ship?
She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please.
Like, yeah, we got this prototype ship that's advanced, the most advanced technology that we have. We're just gonna set it in a shed in the back. Don't worry about it. Never see it again. Seems irresponsible.
Pathfinder, it's so wonderful to meet you.
Does every spaceship have to have a Scotty ripoff character? I mean, is that completely necessary? It's become like this trope that they have to shove into every sci-fi movie. And I don't understand it.
I look forward to working with you. Likewise. I can't wait to get to work. There hasn't been much to do so far, unfortunately. I've studied all the planetary scans. I've even had some hands-on experience with Helios soil samples. If you want, I'll send you my analysis on the native bacteria and microfauna. 60 pages.
Yikes! I don't even want to read one page of dialogue, much less 60 pages about bacteria and small, tiny plants. That's long.
That's a lot of pages. About dirt.
Yeah.
Oh,
dirt.
You don't have to be kind. I know it's barely more than a summary. Anyway, I've waited
months
to get out
there to see Helios. You consider that a summary?
It's
man,
why I joined
my description of the dirt would be like two lines. They'd ask, how would you describe this dirt? I'm like, well, it's dirty. And that's it.
Ones who got to step out of that
end of summary.
It's incredible.
The first time I handled a Prothean artifact, I was hooked. It was so alien.
Who are the Protheans again? I forgot.
There's more out there, and I want to see all of it.
What, the
I
dirt?
I totally know what you mean. So will you be joining us on missions? Oh.
No, I don't think so.
That's funny. Me, out there, with the guns and the danger and everything.
Oh, I can already get romance stuff. Ooh. Now the question is, will they let me romance anybody, everybody, or does it have to be one person? Let's go, yeah.
I'm good with guns and danger. I could teach you and make sure you're okay out there.
Really?
Was that supposed to be a pickup line?
Maybe one day, when things are more
settled. Is that what that was?
I couldn't imagine.
Who writes this? Whoa. I'm like phasing it out of reality.
And I really should go over them later then.
All right, let's go creep on some more people. Ooh. Let's go into the bowels of the ship. Oh, that looks great. There we go, that's better. Is this my cabin?
Your quarters.
Oh my god!
Down there too.
This is the craziest view ever! Oh, I can only imagine waking up to see a new planet every day. Or a big ball of dirt, whatever. Holy shit, what can I fuck with in here? Sam, I've already talked to you. Email. Whoa, hold on. SpaceX rocket model. Oh, that's it? That was extremely helpful. Wardrobe. Oh, that's a cool jacket. I like that. Yeah. Whoa, oh, cool. Ooh. Hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah, we can do colors? Totally. I love colors. What color am I messing with? We'll make that bright red. I don't know what colors these are. Oh, you know what we need to do? How do I do the thing with the... There it is. Okay. I want to be purple. I want to be the brightest dude on the battlefield so they know what's up. Maybe I'll dress up like a watermelon. Oh, yeah, that's loud and obnoxious. I like that. I think digital camo is the way to go. I like it. It's like grape camo. Why did I say watermelon? Oh. I'm thinking bright pink. Oh, yeah, this has really come together nicely. You know what? I think purple was better. Awesome. I like it. My crew's gonna look at me when I disembark and be like, she's the leader. We're screwed. Finally, I found somebody.
Clean air.
I was starting to think I was the only person on this ship besides Cheeto Man and Scotty.
On your mind?
That's a good question.
Maybe.
How can the air be any different in here? I mean, I'd assume all the air goes through the same filtration system
on
this ship.
What the hell was that?
I can't imagine it's very efficient to have a different system for every room.
It's just my biotics reacting to all this.
Reacting?
I don't normally lose it like that.
That sounds bad.
A Huntress should have better control. Huntress? Another term for an Asari commando. I was one before the initiative.
Cool.
Some things stick, though. Like losing the old man.
Yeah, let's talk. We can be nice, right?
I know
it's
not the same, but I'm a good listener. I hope you're as good at being Pathfinder.
That's kind of bitchy, but all right.
And I meant it. But I prepped for years as your father's second. Then
okay, yeah, I did kind of shit on you.
An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Well, he was dying at the time, so who knows?
I don't want a rival.
Lack of oxygen to all of his internal organs.
It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive.
And when I die, I'll pick someone else besides you.
Came out here for.
I'm going to romance. Let's romance everybody.
You, me, side by side. I like the sound of that. A commando friend said something like that once. I explained I wasn't into
women. I'm surprised she understood what she meant, because that was the most non-pickup line I've ever heard.
So I said I'd still take a bullet for her.
She basically said, let's be comrades. Sounds good. And you're like, I don't swing that way.
Look, there's still the mission. A lot of dreams to fulfill. Even if we get there, there's a mountain of hard work ahead. Working hard was never my problem.
Now that's a double entendre.
I always like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place.
You know, I think I finally pinpointed why their facial animations were so kind of... Kind of off.
If this mission succeeds.
It's the eyebrows.
So I'm seeing it through.
Like their expressions lack emotion because the eyebrows don't move. They kind of just kind of fidget there on their forehead, like epileptic caterpillars.
Some Asari expertise. If you want to talk, I'll be here.
Whoa! What the? Where'd I go? There I am. All right, time to meet the next sucker. I mean crew member.
You're not Harry. The blue give it away?
No, she's pretty hairless, actually.
Was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years in the Hyperion looking after your brother.
Wait, was Harry the guy with, like, the floppy arms who didn't know how to use them? Good, because he's the last
Happy
doctor I want operating
Dr.
on me.
I'll do my best.
Him and his fucking noodle arms.
Ow. Sorry.
You want to give me a warning next time before you stab me?
Gentler touch. Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
Ah, you'll be fine.
I couldn't be in better hands. I just stabbed you. We all have off days.
Well,
I always hoped to work in the
field.
Yeah,
that's true.
Everything's happening so quickly. Focus on the positive. It helps. I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
I don't think it'll be that hard. I mean, we've been mowing those dudes down left and right.
For autopsy.
Just walking over piles of their bodies.
I'm not greedy. Why do you care about the Ket?
We'll do autopsies on them so we can kill them better. There's your answer. My turn. Why do you ask stupid questions?
My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
I kind of want to try romancing everybody, see what happens.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe. Thing is, Ryder, you're not my type.
Shit.
What's your type? Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically without distractions.
That's a fair assessment.
Am
no, professional.
Not nearly as much as you think you are. But we were discussing the Ket.
Shut down!
Potential weaknesses, average lifespan. Right. Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables.
That was a weird... Ooh, that's a weird way to end that conversation. Eat your vegetables. Next!
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
Oh, hey, it's Vetra.
The Pathfinder's there?
I completely forgot you were here.
Fine, but don't embarrass me.
You and your magical
Ryder, this is Sid,
reading glasses.
Sid,
how
Ryder.
Do those things work? That baffles me
Hope
still.
I'm not interrupting something important. Not at all. We were just finishing up.
Wait, Ryder, I just
She's
wanted
got
to
Witcher
know...
eyes. Nifty.
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work.
Well,
I know
that's very convenient.
The crew, even the actuators.
Because, work's what we gotta do.
Better, I know how to get
Because, you know, this ain't no carnival cruise.
Me around, your crew's going to be
Although I feel
best.
Like that would be the next step for a
We've
cruise
been
like
for months, Ryder.
A cruise is
now
just
a
big
a
boat going
here.
Nowhere in the ocean. So, logically, the next evolution of that would be a big boat going nowhere in space. Yeah, we'll try. I feel like the romancing will just
sounds
fail.
Like you've got many. Welcome aboard.
Yep, making deals to get the things you
maybe
want.
Maybe I should get to know people before I start
That's me.
Trying to get in their pants.
We all
just
have
a thought.
Personal stake in this. If it keeps going the way it's been, we're all dead. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later?
We barely chatted now, so I don't see why not. Yeah, can I keep talking to her? Well, that was weird.
Hey, Ryder.
Ugh, so many choices. Man, God, I wish I had a dice right now. That way I could just
I made sure
do a roll of dice and let fate decide what we do.
Leadership wanted to strip her for parts, but I kept saying, a Pathfinder's gonna show up.
What is this obsession with destroying perfectly good ships? I mean, seriously, as far as I know, the only thing they've done before I got here was tear shit apart for parts.
Some of it in personal
no one tried to, like, fix the situation they were in.
You just have to
irritating.
And what they're willing to take in exchange.
It can't be that simple.
Oh, but it is. Most things are simple once you know the trick to them.
Yeah, try saying that to an astrophysicist.
We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Alright, so far, Vetra's my favorite, crew person. I think he's the last person in here, isn't he?
Pathfinder, making the rounds.
Random Slumber guy, doing nothing.
Wanna see,
see?
How the
Duke can play that game.
Out.
No coins, so I'll have to make decisions like a big boy. Get my big boy britches on.
Hey, this is the most important part of the ship.
Whoa, don't tell me they put someone smart in charge for a change. I am at your command.
Good.
Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
Kneel before me.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between next.
Now, the real question no one's asking is, can you supercharge a spaceship?
Stretching our wings, you know?
We shall find out.
Too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
Yeah, they don't seem very useful. They just kind of sit around waiting for shit to happen.
Yes, but it's a new thing for me, regret. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose.
You're not very interesting to listen to.
Maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda.
I keep running into these crazy people who think they'll find what they're looking for if they go to the next galaxy.
On that station.
Like, that's kind of far, isn't it?
I was when you showed up.
Seriously, that's like trying to find a decent burger for lunch, and instead of going down the street, you go to the next city over. Fucking idiots. I'll do more than show up. Yeah, let's see what's up.
Happy to be of service. I think you'll see that showing up is only one of my many talents.
Oh yeah? You're not hitting on me, are you?
She is the most awkward human being in the galaxy.
Is it not one of my many talents?
I'm just not susceptible, if you know what I mean. Liam's more my speed.
Oh my god, everyone's turning me down!
Got it.
Why does nobody want me?
No swear
am I
though.
Ugly? Is
you
that
just
it?
Keep pointing this ship wherever you
want. I have
to
a
go,
great person.
Sure
actually, my personality is kind of awkward
Deal?
And weird.
Deal.
Maybe that's why. I'm dedicated to make my entire crew feel really awkward around me. They're chatting over coughs. She's like, they're like, oh, Ryder was really hitting on me yesterday. Like, oh, you too? Yeah, she's really creeping on me. Uncomfortable. And I walk in, it just dead silence. And I'm like, oh, yeah. No, maybe I should keep it in my pants.
Right.
I keep getting lost in my ship. And I feel like there's someone else I haven't talked to
yet. I take it you work closely with the Nexus Science team? I tried to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here.
Let me guess.
After
dirt.
All, many
you talk about
are better
dirt.
Than one. And Dr.
I thought
Aridana
so.
Is worth two or three at least. I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
Well, yeah, otherwise you're just stuck in a little box talking to yourself, and then they put you in a box with padded walls.
How long have you been awake in Helios? Not as long as some. Missed the entire mess of the uprising, thank heaven. I was defrosted to replace an exiled member of the team. Not that there was much science
if
to do
Star Trek has taught
time.
Me one thing, it's you
so
should never exile people.
Helped
because then they
could.
Come back
made
evil,
for science
vengeful, and more powerful
spent
somehow.
Spent some time on an investigation, figuring out how long the food would last if the worst happened. Who's essential, who's not.
Man, they're
what?
Really picky with their people
don't
at the unfreeze. They're just like, nah, he's not worth it. Keeping him in there. I'm like, well, you don't know until you try, do you? Gotta love this awkward silence and creepy stares. Don't worry, don't mind that. That
I'm
was just
so
a
sorry.
Space dog.
I can't believe you had to do that. With no arcs, no pathfinders, we had to plan for the worst. I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home. It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million years out of date. So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the Geths. You're kidding.
Huh.
Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way? Those exact ones. The Initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct.
We're still dealing
According
with their bullshit?
To Aridana,
God damn.
The Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor. FTL sensor.
Faster than light.
So a faster than light telescope? They could
I'd
survey
like to see
Andromeda
you explain how that works.
Not exactly, but it cut down the lag by.
It's still faster
enough.
Than light, which is
we
pretty impressive, and as far as we know, impossible.
In beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Yeah, they're probably looking for another sentient species
How
to irritate.
How did the Initiative even
Maybe
get its hands on Geth
someone that
knowledge.
Doesn't fight back
they're
so much.
They're isolationist and hostile. I don't know, Ryder. Maybe I don't want to know.
They weren't that hostile. I think Shepard had one in his crew at one point. Oh, the Scourge. Let's
what
learn about
the
giant angry space cloud.
That it's artificial. Someone
actually, it looks more like a
or they
evil
did
funnel cake.
That caused its creation. We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
Oh, okay. I guess there's nothing else to talk to you about.
Sounds good.
Yeah, sure. Let's talk to Cheeto Man.
What can I do for you?
Oh yeah, let's learn more about the ship they're just gonna lock away in a storage closet to collect dust.
Just about everything. By memory, it was quite the effort to get her working. The initiative needed absolutely up-to-date technology, which we all had to coordinate, and some of it was rather tricky to acquire.
Let me guess, it fell off the back of a truck?
Legally and above board, of course. Yes. Sadly, the other
secretly acquire
were lost when the Scourge hit the Nexus. The Tempest is truly unique.
We know about the Cheeto people. They're just really clever guys.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Yep, spreading cheese dust all over the chair. Got it. Hello, Blue Lady. Whose name I forget.
Yes?
Memory fragments. Let's learn about those.
I need to talk to you about something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
I thought you were the doctor.
He blocked off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Yeah,
or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe.
I hate that excuse. It is such a bullshit reason not to give me something. Especially if it can help prevent something worse down the line.
From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
So
yeah.
You're telling me he had to
Thanks, Lexi.
Find
Feels
a
good to
path?
Talk about this.
Get it? Pathfinder? No? Okay. Hyperion.
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human arc?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans.
Well, yeah, what defines
also,
alien
Harry
now?
Insisted.
I mean, there's so many races.
Maybe he always intended to switch
jobs.
Yeah,
alien's a pretty relative word. Like, in space where there's a bunch of different sentient creatures out there. It all depends on who's talking about what.
How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis.
That's nice, but not what I asked.
On the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments.
Does surgery really change that much in low-gravity?
So
I mean, besides shit floating around?
I knew we'd be friends.
Fascinating. All right.
Let me get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Yeah, well, if you need me, I won't be anywhere. Gil. What a dumb name.
Long time no chat.
You're an idiot.
What's up?
What's
Do you have any friends?
Oh, I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in.
Yeah, you're
My
hysterical.
My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me.
And so you left her behind?
You'll probably hear about her.
Great. That sounds...
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it.
Why don't you just bust ass from the beginning?
Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
Okay.
How tough has it been on the Nexus all these months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
Well, I have no answer for that. I mean, first of all, I have no idea what space... Is space cow like a flying manatee? Like I'm trying to picture a space cow.
Hasn't everyone?
I mean, is it just like a cow that floats in space?
It's
or just a cow that lives on a planet out in space?
Die from a critical
See, now I'm really curious about space cows.
Starvation? Imagining which would be worse? But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in
I don't know,
fun.
I mean...
What was your take on
Galaxy's
that?
Galaxy's pretty large.
I didn't place
been around
bets,
for a while.
If that's what you're asking.
Chances are
Truth
pretty
is,
good. Something worse has happened.
Well. Whatever side
you know,
you're
just
on,
throw
you
that out there.
When your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Well, my only advice to you is maybe you guys shouldn't recruit assholes and
Seems
dipshits.
Like we have a good
and
group
stuff
here.
Like this probably wouldn't
well,
happen so often.
Are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. As far
hey,
as
you
Hyperion
keep your hands to yourself. Suvi and Vetra are
Doc's
mine.
Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora,
oh my god, where's Liam?
She's a bit by the book for me.
I was so uninterested in talking to him, I forgot he existed.
Need somebody to keep the zoo in check.
Zoo? You calling me an animal rider?
Ooh,
maybe a mongoose? They're like cool cobra killers. No, wait, how about a crow? Smart, irreverent,
yeah,
anxious.
I was thinking more along the lines of Jackass, but you know what? Whatever floats your goat. God, these dialogue trees are so awkward.
What about Kello?
He's a pilot.
Which means?
He flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Well, there's not that many dead ends in space.
Anytime.
I know this conversation's a dead end, so I'm just going to walk away. All right, now where is Liam? What the hell?
Pathfinder, help me with something. I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric
where'd you get a couch?
From an overclocked Omni Blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Wait, what? Yeah.
Right.
Oh,
right.
I should have asked where he found
what?
The couch.
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of
So you basically
trouble,
went from cop
worked.
To crisis response,
you into a few
decided actions. That wasn't enough. And then
think
when I needed to do space crisis response, that's the next level in my training. What is
tell
hustle?
About your group.
Like,
heavy
do the hustle?
Terrain one. Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit.
Hmm. That couch is disgusting. I didn't even look at it first, but
much better on the
those stains
all
look gross.
Tired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded.
I see you moved your beard from your face to your head.
I wanted exploration to chase the cutting edge of Prothean research. I thought I'd found
again
my
with the Protheans.
Seems
why
like a
does
long
it
time
sound
ago.
So familiar?
600 years.
But I can't put take. My finger on it.
So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That
I don't
blunt.
Know. I didn't choose.
That blunt.
I was just along for the ride. Yeah, let's find out what his deal is.
I'm looking for moments like this with people like you.
One, that was weak. And
you
B, you could have stayed home and gone to a bar if you wanted to just drink with random people.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story.
That's corny. Who writes this shit?
But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning.
I don't know, you gotta really believe in something to an extreme extent to travel 600 years to another galaxy just to be a part of it. And I really hate to break it to you, but your family and friends? Probably dead right now.
Wrong. It could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response,
what are you
going to
do? Go back
team.
To the Milky Way?
Leads to planets, leads to people.
Everyone you know is
you
dead,
covered,
so...
You got this. I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
Well, if nothing else, he's motivated, and that's good enough for me. Oh, more.
Pathfinder?
You barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
Great icebreaker.
I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done.
So you were a shitty cop, so they're like, let's send you to the galaxy? How bad do you have to be at your job to be sent across the universe?
You were a cop, then crisis response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Wait a minute, we've already been over this. We just talked about this like 2 minutes ago.
Dad knew it didn't fit before I did, but it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
An impatient rookie, frustrated by procedure. That's overdone.
I know, right?
They're poking fun
you,
at the cliched writing in their own game. What the
I
hell?
Your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does.
Oh yeah, totally. You
Mom
know, just
Joel,
sit there, curl up a ball,
Calvin,
cry,
both lawyers,
and just shove gallons of ice cream in your face.
No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional.
So you'd miss your siblings, but not your friends and parents. Your logic's a little fucked up.
Traditional is a weird term for family.
like, normal. Who's that describe?
I suppose you're right. I sure didn't keep to tradition. I said goodbye to my mom and dad, and got on a ship to Andromeda.
Oh yeah, I would have loved to see how that played out. He walks in and goes, sorry mom, sorry dad, but your only son's flying off to a galaxy 600 years away. You'll never see me again, or any grandchildren or great-grandchildren you might have had. And I'm not going to be able to take care of you in your old age, and you'll be dead long before I am. But wish me luck! Have we chatted up everyone we can? Alright. This is a good place to stop it then. And that's all the time we got for the crew today. Next time we'll be back on track and exploring the universe. Before I forget, don't forget to hit one of the buttons down there. Thumb up, thumb down, let me know why, please.